61%, whoa. Howdy guys, Nintendo Capri Sun here, and welcome back to Castle in the Darkness. You don't know how weird it feels to say that 10 minutes after you started recording. But basically, I've had nothing but failed attempts so far. So I really don't see the point in showing all that. I mean, oh, this guy's in such a bad spot. There we go. So basically what we're trying to do here is get to this crab boss on full health. If we can do that, we might actually have a chance to beat him. But I've yet to actually do that, so like legitimately, I've yet to do it. It's not that I've done it illegitimately before. I've just literally never done it, so if we can get our strategy right here, we can do this. Now, sorry about the shitty commentary, but after you've been going for 10 minutes, I'm basically doing the same thing over and over again. It's kind of like, oh, okay. I think I said everything there was to say. The commentary wasn't that great anyway. I basically sat here and did the Pollux Troy voice for like 5 minutes. And you're like, oh, rub my nose in it, why don't you? $10 million design. And those foolish enough jobs could keep your cash. Alright, so far so good. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Nail him. Make sure you dodge that stupid fallen rock that comes down after. Oh, great work. Oh. You gave me that extra little half a second there to charge my attack. I appreciate that. You didn't have to do that. You really gotta watch your jumps when you're dodging that laser. Unless you end up in a world of poop. Send me up there happier as a poop! Happy as a Helen Lark! Man, I was so mad on that tape. See, we used to have these friends. Well, Mom and Steve had these friends that came over. And they brought their kids. And their daughter, like, every time she and Mary got together, they always wanted me to get in on stuff that they were doing together. Like, you know, and I just wanted to play video games, but they always wanted me to go upstairs with them and be like, hey, we're gonna do an interview and we want you to be in. You know, I don't know. I mean, these days, I'd probably be more flattered than anything that I was actually getting attention from a girl other than my sister. Dear God. Well, I shouldn't say that. Oh, God! But, yeah. Shit, I didn't charge my spell. We're gonna have to do this live. That's fine. Hey, we're actually doing pretty good this time. Look at this. If I can stop getting hit by that shit. Good lord, man. Pay attention. Pay the fuck attention. Man, I almost missed that. This is gonna be too late. Yeah. For some reason, it just doesn't hit him when he's on his way down. Oh, God. Boy, can you imagine if there was actually knockback in this game? It'd be the most ridiculous thing ever. Dude! Boy, when you mess up, you really mess up, you know? Like, you mess up a tiny bit, and then you mess up a little more on top of that. Next thing you know, you're having an entire orgasm of mess up. Okay, he's got one bar left. We can do this. We don't need to charge up for no sinking spell. You dead? You're still not dead? God, no wonder this took so long without the... without that spell. Here. There we go. Okay, but here's the thing. You gotta pay attention here. Because you're not done when you think you're done. And now, for some reason... oh, thank God. Oh, good, 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 good. Wait! Why did I just stand there on top of him like a dumbass? Why did I do that? Do you have any idea how stupid? Are you kidding me? I can't even laugh. That's not even funny. That's plain stupid, man. Those are Koopas, man. But yeah, like, Mary and Erica would always want me to go upstairs with him. And this one time, I was playing A Link to the Past, and... like, I kept telling her, you know, I gotta beat this guy at the top, because I was in Ganon's Tower, I was about to finish the game. And I kept telling her, you know, I gotta beat this guy at the top of the tower. And literally, she sat there, and every single room that I went into, she would ask, "Is this the guy?" And I'm like, "No, he's at the top of the tower. Like, he's on the 8th floor. Going to the next room, 4 Wizrobes would appear. Is that the guy?" I'm like, "No. Shut up." And just, oh my god, it drove me absolutely insane. You would not believe the level of anger was just... Wow. I could just see that happening before it even did, you know? Oh man, no, don't start with the dirt again, whatever you do. Oh, and then you don't not cast your spell. Because you didn't charge it for long enough. Okay, that was kind of a little bit of RNG failure there, but whatever. Yeah, so my car's in the shop, actually. I had to take it in today because I was getting some grinding when I would brake. That's never a good sign. It actually got to a point where it was grinding even when I drove slow. So, I had to, well, you know, it started making me uncomfortable, so I took it in. So I'm gonna keep it overnight. It's gonna be about $900, but, you know, a guy's gotta do what a guy's gotta do. Well, if he doesn't like that, I'll tell ya. Backs away from that thing as soon as it hits. Ah, oh, man, get away. Oh my god, what the hell? What the hell, man? So what was I saying? Yeah, my car's in the shop. So, I mean, I'm glad I'm getting that done now, because, like, ugh. So I could not live with that if I had to... You know, I've had that on my to-do list for a couple of weeks now. And you would be amazed, you know, how much stress relief there is in just doing stuff. Like, procrastination. It sounds like such an innocent word, you know? It's like, oh, well, you know, I can just do it later. It's not a big deal. It doesn't matter when I do it, as long as I do it. But sometimes that's not the point. What the point is that you're not going to want to do it then any more than you want to do it now. So you might as well do it now and get it out of the way. Especially when you actually go and do it and then it turns out to not be as bad as you thought. Because it turned out to be like a beautiful day and it's like, you know, I'm glad I went and did this. I actually would go so far as to say I have fun. Because, you know, I mean, I took the car in and they looked at it, and meanwhile, I just took a walk outside. It's a nice little place down on Oneida Street. There's a little shopping center next to it, and nothing was open, but that just made the walk all the more pleasant. There's nobody around to stare at me. So, yeah. I had myself a nice, pleasant little time. Came back to the dealership, they told me what was wrong, gave me the statement, it was a little more than I was hoping it would be, but whatever. Considering what they're actually gonna have to do. You know, because I was expecting they were gonna find a bunch of other things too that they were gonna have to do. Cause that's what always happens, you know, it's like you go and take your car and you say, you know, I need to, you know, fix the brakes. And then they come back and tell you, oh, you know what? We found some other stuff here. We got your alternators all fucked up. Your radiator is about to go to shit. Your battery's dead. Then you end up spending $1,200 on something you originally only planned to spend $400 on. They get you on that stuff. There we go. Alright. Maybe one more. Maybe two more. I don't know. It's a rather time-consuming boss, considering... I mean, this is probably the hardest boss we've had to face yet, so... All things considered here. Nope. Oh, you're gonna do that, are you? Oh, really? Jeez, man. Stop dragging this out. This should do it. Yes! Get these bugs out of here, man. Alright, phase two. Let's do it. Let's try to get in a position where he can't dodge it and fly away. Yeah, that was good. Yes! Okay, now stay away from him. Did we actually do it? Oh, dear God. I can't believe I finally beat that son of a gun. Whew! First time ever, baby. Of course, now we just have to make sure we don't jump on the spikes. Kind of tempted to go back to the save point, but... because I have no idea where this is going to go. Yeah. I'm going back. So gonna regret this. But I have to, man. At least I know where this one is. I know how far it is, and I know there's not that many dangers between here and there, so... well, there are, but... maybe not. Dude! The Executioner, yes! I was wondering if I was gonna get that drop in this playthrough. I almost fell in that pit. Can you believe that? Okay, save. So, I'll show the Executioner. I'm not going to equip it just yet. It has attack power 5, but check out the way that this thing... it's like the axe in Castlevania. You know what? Maybe we will actually use this for a while. I don't know. It's something different. As you can see, it makes it a lot easier to hit enemies up in the air like this. However... as you can also see, the diminished attack power will come back to bite us in the ass a little bit here. Well, at least now that we've saved, man, if I hadn't gone back for that save, I wouldn't have gotten that drop. So it's a good thing I did. Let's see where this goes. I can only imagine. What is this? Holy shit! This sword is so powerful, it changed the color of my armor. So really, I had to fight the whole... I mean, so, like, I'm not saying that wasn't worth it, I'm saying it almost seems like that was too good of a reward. Like, did I really only have to fight just one boss for that? I mean, I'd like to say that was challenging, and it was, no doubt about it, but... I'm a little confused right now about how I feel about this. Like, I'm really glad. Don't get me wrong, I'm really glad. So it's 11 as opposed to 10. How big is it, actually? Oh, damn, it's humongous. Good lord. So this is definitely... ooh, yeah, don't fall for that. So it's like, I'm also relieved that it turned out to be a dead end. So now that's one less way to have to worry about going. And also... I don't know, it's just like, I mean, that's like the biggest sword in the game. I didn't expect to be picking that up this early, I guess. There's that too. Oh god, get me out of here. Can I reach this switch from over there? I don't wonder. Well, at least now I can, you know... ugh. At least now I can go this way. And know that I'm going the right way. But the thing is, I know now... now that I know where that other way leads to... now I know where this place goes. This goes to the final boss. I'm actually glad that happened. Because... I was doing shitty anyway. So this actually goes to the final boss here. I know, because I've been through this. I've been to the final boss. But, man, boy, was it a pain in the butt getting there. The mimic right there. We won't worry about that. Shoot. Try that again. Oh, that is so powerful. So, once again, make sure your timing is right on that. Shoot, I need to turn this video off, man. It's almost a half hour here. Of course, I did start, like, 10 minutes in. Yeah, so next time, we're gonna hide behind the statue here. And, see you guys then. This is awkward and, awkward outros for the win. Wow, I cannot speak today.